Matthew 16.
Matthew 16.
We'll read from verse 1.
The Bible will go verse 1.
To 6.
Of it, law 6.
Are you there? And the Pharisees and Sadducees came and tried him, asking him to show them a sign from heaven. But he answered and said unto them, when it is evening, ye say, it will be fair weather, for the heaven is red. And in the morning, it will be foul weather today, for the heaven is red and lowery. Ye know how to discern the face of heaven, but ye cannot discern the sign of times or of the times. An evil and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall no sign be given unto it but the sign of Jonah. And he left them, and he departed them. Can you see there?
Amen.
So let's pray. Father, thank you for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
You can read there until verse 6. I'm going to read verse 6. It says, and Jesus said unto them, take heed and beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and Sadducees. I just want to preach to you a short message that is going to help you. Why are you not getting your miracle? As your neighbor. Why are you not living your life? The truth is, there is a lack of faith. Right, lack of faith. Lack of faith. If you can read there, these people were well known
by the time of Jesus.
It was like a sect of Christians which was called Pharisees, taught under Gamaliel. And they were Sadducees, they were opposing each other. All of them, they developed their own philosophies. But you know, when Jesus came, he came with simple words coming from a low family. A family that the father was just working a funny job.
Carpenter.
But when you read here on verse 1,
you can say that they
came in a right spirit of saying, show us a sign. Just show us a sign of heaven. If you can see there, you realize that they never believe in him. What was the reason of show us a sign? Why they wanted to see a sign anyway? It was a sign that they will say, we don't believe in you. Can you prove you are coming from there? These people, they never had faith. Because if you can hear my topic of lack of faith,
we're
talking about little faith. It means faith was not there. These people, they had no faith. They are coming to find out if you will do 1, 2, 3. Maybe they will
do it. If you do 1, 2, 3,
Jesus says, there is a sign
wana lesika
that God will give you
sa hore mose modimo tla lefang sona
so that you believe in me
hore le gone o dumela ge go nna.
It's a sign of Jonah
ke seka sa Johana
that I will die and be buried
sa hore ke tlo go ka molokwa ka tla ka tsoa hape
habedi. You need that kind of sign
re tlhoka seka sa mofuta wo.
But he went further
jana nge na tshola pele ge a bolela
re verse 3
he
was content because they were educated.
They could
read
weather.
They look at weather, they say now it will be like this. But they could not understand the times of God. You must understand God's time. If you understand God's time, you will never lack faith. Because you know that God will bless you by His time. These ones, they try to question Him. And this does not even benefit them. They were just coming to say, Jesus,
prove
if truly you are coming from above. Jesus said, you are defining everything. But you don't know the time of God. In other words, you are still even lacking faith for yourself. I found that many people are going to church. They have faith for other people. But they don't have the faith of themselves. People have got faith for other people. But they don't have faith of themselves. If you have faith of other people, and you don't have faith of yourself, we say you are lacking faith. Because somewhere you are not living your life. The Bible says the just shall live by faith. Therefore, it means somewhere you are not living your life. There is a life you are living, but there is somewhere you are not living. Your life. He who lacks faith lacks his life. He is not fulfilled. We need Christians today who will have faith. And the Bible says, even if it can be little, even if it can be small, like a mustard seed, it can do big things. Tell my friend, somewhere you are lacking faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read Matthew 13, you just go back on verse 54.
Matthew 13, verse 54.
If you read there to 58, let me read for you. And coming into his own country, he taught them in their synagogue, in so much that they were astonished and said, whence has this man this wisdom and these mighty works? Is it not this the carpenter's son? Is it not his mother called Mary, and his brethren James and Joseph and Simon and Judas? And his sisters, are they not all with us? Whence then has this man all these things? And they were offended in him.
Amen.
But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor save in his own country and his own house.
Amen.
Can you see that verse there? And he did not many mighty works there because of their unbelief. If you can check there. Let me read in Amplified Bible.
Or maybe
another version. Can you just read for me in Amplified Bible or King James Version?
Verse 58.
Read it aloud if you
know.
It says what?
Verse 57. So they were offended at him.
Uh-huh.
But Jesus said to them, a prophet is not without honor except in his own country.
58.
And 58 says, now he did not do many mighty works there because of their unbelief.
He did not do mighty works there.
There
were places Jesus was going for mighty works.
But there,
Because they lack faith. Jesus didn't want to be embarrassed. Can you see that you are trying to bring a miracle to somebody who don't believe? You can be very much embarrassed. Sometimes we were preaching the gospel, we question why we pray for people and nothing happened. And we ask ourselves many questions. So Jesus could check faith first. Tell somebody, my friend. Jesus could check faith first. He could not just start up and pray for people. He checked who's having faith.
And I don't
think that you can check that the Bible says. He could not do mighty works. There are miracles, there are mighty works. There are things that are done because people are believing. If you and me, we have faith, we can do mighty things.
Mighty works.
They are limited because people are not believing. If you can read there, you realize that these people knew Jesus. And they question, where did he get the power? This thing is still happening today. The moment God began to use you, people question, where did you get what you are doing? But that's because they understood you according to their perspectives. They already written you off. They can be surprised to find you are the one out of faith who can come out with the best result. I want to tell you today, as long as you're not lacking faith, there's mighty works that are coming upon your life. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Jesus could not do mighty works because they were offended. They had questions. Can I tell you something? Any questions that rises out of your mind affect your faith. Also, it just make your faith to be small. Whatever is not of faith is bound to go back to zero. Are you hearing me? If you are doing whatever you are doing, without faith, check very soon. You'll be surprised you are zero. You'll be surprised what Jesus said. When he said the first shall be the last, and the last shall be, it will happen to you. So lack of faith is dangerous. It just nullify you. Here,
yeah,
the brothers of Jesus were there. People began to think about the brother of Jesus. We know them. It means they were nothing. When they read Jesus, they read the brothers, they were supposed to conclude and say they are the same. Why Jesus is doing this? They were offended. They lack faith. But the power of God was there. But Jesus could not do mighty works. Today, as you are believing, you will receive mighty works. I say you will receive mighty works. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read Romans 3 verse 3, it shows that our lack of faith does not change the mind of God. In other words, God is still the same God you know. Somebody can still receive big things. Another one, zero. You can't affect God negatively by lacking of faith. The same God, you need to have faith to draw from him. As long as we are here, we have got different kind of faith.
Here.
You have got little faith. I mean, you have got growing faith. You have got already temptation faith. You've got bold faith. You've got strong faith. You've got victory faith. But the truth is, when you have to draw from Jesus, it won't be the same. If you lack faith there, you are affected there. Many of you here, where you are affected, know this. That's where your faith is needed. Don't lose your power. Don't lose your trust. Don't lose whatever that God has given you. Carry on believing that you can change the situation you are facing. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What are you facing? Whatever you are facing is asking God, do you have faith there? In Matthew 17, verse 14 to 20, the Bible says, they were proved by the situation. They were proved. And Jesus, when he saw that they failed, he was not happy with them. It's 17 there. When they asked Jesus, why we failed, Jesus says, you lack faith. Jesus never wasted time. He said, where you failed there, you lack faith there. They went to Jesus. We're supposed to have casted that demon and healed that child. But we have failed.
Why?
You gave us power. You sent us out. But why we fail here? Jesus said, no. Don't talk against power. You still have power. But you failed to send out that power. Because the main problem is when you fail to use what God has given. Let me give you an example. You know, there are some people who have trained. I saw someone who was trained so much. And then he was beaten so much. And beaten, he ended up falling down, kicked. When he wake up there, he said, hey, I don't know why that man beat him. And we told him, but you have trained.
Mara, when I trained, he
said, yes, I even forgot that I have trained. We say, why you forgot that you have trained?
Why will live it?
He gave us a real answer. He said, because I offended that man. I offended him, so I could not beat him. Can I tell you something? Many of you are failing to use that faith because you are offending God. Somewhere you are not living right. So you are bound to be beaten up on the left, beaten up on the right. And there's nothing you can do because already you have offended. So you have offended. Otherwise, when you are beating that one, you are beating yourself. I don't know if you're hearing me. There is someone here who is listening to me. Today, God is raising you. Out of your faith, you can receive healing. You'll receive blessings. Your heart desire. And I see you with a big testimony. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Gospel without faith is useless. This is not the time that you must beg. You know, I found that many of us we know, but somewhere we are lacking faith. Whatever you are facing, it just needs you to have faith. Any pain you are experiencing, it will never kill you. You might be facing what you are facing. Use faith until faith brings out results.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
Don't
come to where I am.
Until what you are saying,
until
it happens, and you will never fail again. We need Christians who can say, yes, I don't have money, but they speak money unto their lives. I don't know if you're hearing me. They speak money until they have money. We need Christians who have got pain. As they are feeling a severe pain, they are still talking with the pain. Pain. You are not part of me. You are leaving me. You are not part of me. You are leaving me. That pain will end up says, this man, he's having faith. I must go. And the pain will go. That's what I say, my friend. Faith is life. You don't just wake up in the morning.
I know what I was saying.
You find that you are grown up. You just go.
I
don't know if you're hearing me. So the reason why you are lacking faith is because today you have got big faith. Tomorrow you are discouraged. Today you are questioning why they are not calling you. Yesterday they say they will call you. We need Christians who are saying, even if they are not calling, I know they won't have peace until they call me. Those Christians, they will receive whatever they say. They will receive whatever they say. Even you today, you are receiving whatever you say. If you believe, shout hallelujah. You must read the Bible. It's all about faith. Jesus will use faith. Can I tell you a challenge that has happened? Jesus was using faith that day. There was no way Jesus could get inside the grave of Lazarus and stretch the hand.
He
will be discouraged. Jesus didn't want to see how Lazarus will be formed
again.
When the stone was rolled, everybody closes
mouth.
That was the only Jesus alone who was standing. And he was also discouraged. We cannot roll. Because it's the fourth day, he might be smelling. But Jesus said, I know what I have said there. Jesus never overcame when he was there. He had a faith from the beginning when he was told that Lazarus is sick. He said, no, the sickness is not unto death. When Lazarus died, when he said, let's go there, one of the disciples said, please, let's go and die with him. Another one said, let us not go there. It was danger for Jesus to go to Bethany for his life. But he knew he's supposed to go there because from the beginning he started with faith and he's supposed to end with faith. He never lacked faith. So when he reached there, when he see Martha crying, when Martha was speaking out of doubt, he said, okay, I won't even get to the city. I'm standing here. When she went to call Mary, when Mary cried, he cried. Jesus might have cried, seeing Mary. That Mary is crying because he loves Mary. And the Bible said Jesus wept. But when he was outside there, carrying on with faith, he said, roll the stone. And he said, listen to the prayer of faith. I know you have heard me. You have heard me from where? From the beginning. I never lack faith. From where? From the beginning. I know you have heard me. Somewhere you Christians, you are lacking faith somewhere. Because of the challenges you are facing and the questions you are being questioned. Don't mind about what you are facing. Believe that God can still accomplish or give you what you have been praying and believing from the beginning. Don't look back and worry. God is the same God. He's Alpha and Omega. He knows from the beginning where is your faith. He knows at the end where is your faith. Jesus says, Lazarus, come forth. I'm sure people will say, like your friends, look, he's crying. He doesn't even understand that this man.
And they
say, is he not the one who healed Humo?
But I saw now,
is he not the one who's working where?
But I saw
is he not the one who's driving this car?
I
the one who stayed there. Why is he failing here? Because you know, people look at you and look at your achievement and they look where you have failed. But today, when you're not lacking faith, you will speak like Jesus. Lazarus, come forth. My job, come forth. My business, come forth. There is something that has been hidden in the grave. It's waiting for the voice of faith. Today, whatever you say, it shall come to pass in the place, this place. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Are you ready to do this? Are you not lacking faith? How many of you are lacking faith? If you are lacking faith, I want to tell you, just confess that doubt out of you. And confess unbelief. And say, I'm sorry, Lord. I'm standing by faith. From today, whatever I say, it shall come to pass. I want to tell you, don't look at your past. Don't look at your presence. Look at the ability of your God. God wants to honor you today. When you speak by faith, you are going to receive today in the name of Jesus. Are you ready? Congratulations. Gracias.